This time, I'm going to talk about Merton Jump-Diffusion process in Python. The Merton Jump-Diffusion process is a mathematical model used in finance to describe asset price dynamics, incorporating both continuous price changes and sudden discontinuous jumps. In Black-Scholes model, we have continuous price changes. On top of that, we will account for observed market phenomena like large sudden price movements. Then we will get Merton jump diffusion process. Let's take a look at the key components of Merton jump diffusion process. The first part is continuous component. So, just like in Black-Scholes model, you can see ST is asset price at time t. Mu is a drift. Also, it's expected return. And sigma is the volatility of the asset. And WT is standard Brownian motion. Then we will add the second item, the jump component. The sudden changes or jumps in the asset price are modeled using a Poisson process. In this formula, Z is a random variable representing the jump size, typically assumed to be normally distributed. Then we'll combine the two components. The first part is the continuous process, and the second part is the jump. In pricing derivatives, the process is transformed under the risk-neutral measure, adjusting the drift to include the expected effect of jumps. If we did not adjust for jumps, the process would incorporate excess returns due to the jumps, violating the risk-neutral assumption. In my model, we will use characteristic function. A characteristic function is a mathematical tool used primarily in probability theory and statistics. It provides an alternative representation of a random variable's distribution. Let's take a look at this formula. If we have a random variable x here, and it has a probability density function fx here, then the characteristic function is defined with this formula. Why we use characteristic functions? Characteristic functions are Fourier transforms of probability distributions and are often easier to work with for sums, convolutions, and transformations than directly manipulating probability, density, or cumulative distribution functions. It can facilitate computation for complex models, link to statistical properties, and handle distributions without explicit densities. And also, characteristic functions can enable density reconstruction. So in my model, I'm going to use characteristic functions for this Merton jump diffusion. Now, let's go to our model and run our model. This is my model for the Merton process. I will upload this source code to my GitHub so you can download the source code and modify the parameters and run it by yourself. First, we'll define the parameters here. I have all the definition for all the parameters here in the comment. And then we will have this function to calculate Merton density. And here is my characteristic function. Here I will define Gil-Pelaez PDF function. So this formula will calculate the inversion of a characteristic function. And I will have a plot to plot Merton density and Gil-Pelaez PDF and histogram of simulated value XT. This XT is a simulated value for our Merton process. And then I will compare the XT, the simulated result, with the normal distribution with a QQ plot. And then I will calculate all those parameters for our distribution and compare the calculated average growth rate and theoretical average growth rate. Lastly, I will compare the parameters I calculated with maximum likelihood estimation with the original parameters. Okay, now let's run our model. Okay, now we got our result. In this graph, the red line is the Merton density. It represents the theoretical probability density function of our Merton jump diffusion process, calculated analytically. And this blue dot is our Fourier inversion. That's the density calculated using the characteristic function and the Gil-Pelaez inversion formula. You can see these points align closely with the theoretical curve. So our calculation is accurate. And this light blue area is the frequencies of XT. As I mentioned before, the XT is our simulated result. This light blue area is the histogram of the simulated values from the process. These represent the empirical distribution based on the simulation. Now, let's take a look at this QQ plot. In this central region, you can see the points closely follow the red line, indicating that the middle portion of the data matches the theoretical distribution pretty well. And if you look at this part and this part, the red tail rises above the line and the left tail falls below the line. This suggests that the data exhibits heavier tails than the theoretical distribution. Here, we use normal distribution as our theoretical distribution. So that means it has more extreme values than expected. And you can see a dot here. This is the outlier. And we also calculated the median, mean, standard deviation, and skewness, kurtosis. And now we compare the calculated average growth rate and the theoretical average growth rate. You can see, basically, they are the same. If you stop here, it's about 0.23. And lastly, we used the maximum likelihood estimation to estimate those parameters. You can compare one by one. You can see all those parameters are very close between the original parameter and the MIL parameter. This is how you can create Merton jump diffusion process in Python. Please comment, like, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.